So, it is by no doubt that the sound assistant brings better visuals and gives you a great experience on your device considering you're running Android 10 or 11. Of all the toggles the sound assistant brings, the equalizer is by far the best so far. It enhances your listening experience and gives you power over adjusting the instrumentals, vocals, trebles, and bass just by a single tap. Overall, the visuals for One UI 3.0 default volume theme aren't preferably my style. It's distractive and not user-friendly for one-handed use as compared to the sound assistant volume theme. And considering you like your sound equalized, the toggle is not provided by default. Also, the settings icon do not give you as much. It is by far less functional as compared to the settings icon the sound assistant volume has to offer. Here, by pressing the icon, you will dive straight into the sound assistant app settings with plenty of stuff to play around with. Without wasting so much of your time, let's dive into the tips and tricks for the sound assistant. So, volume panel theme is a must turn on toggle. Inside this module, you can adjust the layout position either to the left or to the right, depending on the hand that you use on your device, as well as choosing the color. If you barely receive calls and consume content on your device, then consider turning this on so that you can easily adjust the volume for all your media apps using the volume rocker. If it's turned off, it simply means the volume button will be by default controlling the system volume. Now, with the individual app volume, you can mute volume for certain apps or set any application's volume to your desired level. I mute sounds for most apps that brings random pop-up ads with sound. Believe me, this feature is very helpful. Media Manner mode authorizes the mute and vibration toggle to mute even the media sound on your device when they are turned on. A clear example would be me setting it at 10. I will only need to press the volume slider 15 times to get the volume to 150, meaning the number of times needed to get your volume to the maximum will always be the maximum volume over the change slider value. Multisound allows you to play music from two or more different apps at once on your smartphone. If you have two audio output sources, maybe your wearables and your phone speakers, whenever I'm connected to my Bluetooth device, my Galaxy Buds, all my WhatsApp audios will play from them. Step volume allows you to change the rate at which your volume can increase or decrease. Then, in the process, experience a slight lag in between the two. The Bluetooth metronome can help you sync them by simply adjusting the slider left or right. This is where you find the main EQ settings, which allows you to adjust the volume level to frequencies within any audio signal. And by tapping the more options, you can choose to turn on Dolby Atmos for all your media apps as well as for gaming. And pressing the adaptive sound allows you to set sound in a way that you can get the
separate
best
app sound allows you to choose
the output device to which you want to hear
simply
particular
by
having a test of listening to beeps of different frequencies. When setting this up, consider being in a quiet room. To simulate different reverb, like for example one for a concrete hall over here, you need to turn off the Dolby Atmos. Last but not least, you can set your favorite media player over here, the one that you always get music from when you press the play button on your headphones. You can also turn this on so that you can always get your notification alerts through your headphones. Some of the toggles, like the reverse stereo, I haven't found where I can use them, but I'm sure they are worth checking out if it's your first time. This is an EQ in its simplest form, which lets you turn the trebles and bass up and down, allowing you to adjust the coloration.
Thank you.